సిలబస్ ఏమైనా తప్పు చేసిందా? చూసి మరి పైకి ఎత్తండి. సో వాట్ డిడ్ యూ అండర్స్టాండ్ ఆఫ్ ద సిలబస్ ఫర్ గ్రూప్ టూ? హ్యాస్ ఇట్ బికమ్ ఈజీ ఆర్ డిఫికల్ట్? యూర్ టూ ఫార్, యూ హ్యావ్ టు కమ్ ఫార్వర్డ్. ఇదేమైనా థియేటర్? ఆ లాస్ట్ బెంచ్ లో కూర్చుంటే బాగా అనిపిస్తుంది అనుకోవడానికి. ఎస్, హౌ, వాట్ డిడ్ యూ ఫైండ్ అబౌట్ ద గ్రూప్ టూ సిలబస్? అమ్మా, ఈ ముందు ప్యాటర్న్ బాగుందా, ఇప్పుడు ప్యాటర్న్ బాగుందా? దిస్ ఈజ్ ఈజీ యాక్చువల్లీ. లెట్స్ స్టార్ట్ విత్ గ్రూప్ టూ. లెట్స్ అండర్స్టాండ్ ద ప్యాటర్న్ ఫస్ట్. గ్రూప్ టూ APPSC, ది ఓన్లీ చేంజ్ హ్యాస్ హ్యాపెండ్ ఇన్ ప్రిలిమ్స్. ప్రిలిమ్స్ నౌ విల్ హ్యావ్ 3 సెక్షన్స్, ఏ, బి అండ్ సి. 1 పేపర్, సింగిల్ పేపర్. Do not write, please first listen, 150 marks, okay. A will be general studies, stop talking, and mental ability. Then meaning entante, we can expect more questions from mental ability because it is directly mentioned in your paper name, title. B will have Indian polity, and what else is there? AP. Actually, AP history. C will have economy, India and AP. The same 3 sections have been converted into, when it comes to mains, has been converted into paper 1, paper 2 and paper 3. Okay, technically speaking, it should be 50 marks here. We really don't know the division, it's just an assumption. 50 marks here and 50 marks here. The same will translate into 150 marks for paper 1, 150 marks for paper 2 and 150 marks for paper 3. Paper 1 will be general studies. Paper 2 will be Indian polity and AP history. I don't see any change in the syllabus as well. Paper 3 is going to be, deentro aithe there is no big change. Paper 3 is going to be economy, Indian economy plus AP economy. Now, did you observe any change in your economy paper? Is there any change in your economy paper? No? As it is, all topics are covered the same way. Do you have the same division? Indian economy 5 chapters, AP economy 5 chapters. There is a change. But in this, they have integrated topics. For example, if you read about industries general and India, immediately you will have industries AP. They have aligned the areas. This is for your benefit, and the continuity law, you will be able to finish it off. So this is an advantage. Okay. Now, general studies will have these areas. Current affairs is the first area. You only have modern Indian history. You don't have ancient and medieval is not there. Similarly, you only have Indian and state geography. Okay, you have disaster management. Environment is listed separately. Sciences and science and technology, mental ability, logical reasoning, 2 topics, data interpretation is also there, plus data interpretation. And finally, bifurcation issues is there, but the content of bifurcation issues has become current. This has to be taught more from an economic perspective, ongoing projects, problems with respect to investments and so on. Our part ekwa kavarin. So these are the areas you have in General Studies Paper 1. Polity, history. Na prakaram aithe, this is going to be very important. Okay. This is going to be very important. Expect at least 20 marks from current affairs. Expect at least 25 to 30 marks from this area. The rest of them will be evenly distributed. You have polity also in this paper, but polity basically is polity and e-governance, good governance topics have been included. So, you know, this part is additional for you for prelims, I mean for paper 1. So, this is your syllabus in totality for APPSC group 2. Now, make a note of it first. So, the biggest advantage of this will be you're going to holistically prepare for both prelims and mains. You don't need a separate preparation for prelims, separate preparation for mains undadu. Now, group 1 is where you have the maximum change, and group 1 notification this year is very important because you have a number of posts. I'm sure you will not get this kind of notification again in the next 10 years. Any idea on the number of posts in group 1? No? Yes? Kind of posts is also very, very good. As far as my information goes, there will be nearly 60 deputy collector posts. So, group 1, there has been a lot of change. Group 1 prelims, they introduced the two papers. Now, this is where you have to follow it carefully. Paper 1 will have four areas. He has mentioned it as history and culture. The reason why it is mentioned as history and culture is because it includes both India and AP. Kani, the topics are selective. Continuity lo ledu syllabus, it is selective. And he focused more on socio-cultural history. If you notice the syllabus, most of the second, third, fourth and fifth units are socio-cultural. Renaissance, contribution of different leaders, avanni unnai. So this part is more to do with socio-cultural and it is selective. Topics are very neatly defined. The second area is very lengthy. This is first. Second area is very lengthy. He says polity, constitution, social justice. Kani, you don't have many topics related to social justice. It is only one topic, that is welfare mechanisms and international relations. You have only one unit on international relations. Kani, problem entante, when it is given like this, ippadu variki meeru utti current affairs chadave vallu international. Ippudu koncham you have to look at the basics also. Important organizations background, India foreign policy, key factors, itlanti konni areas kuda chusukovalsi vastundi because he has mentioned it not in current affairs but as a separate area. Third is economy, AP, India. And the fourth area is geography. Okay. So clearly the four core areas of the syllabus are given in your first paper. Division should be, you know, four areas and we have 150 marks. So it should be roughly about 35 marks per area, but we cannot predict because it's not clarified on that. Now what is paper 2? 120 marks, sorry. 120 marks, but we don't know, it is not clarified whether it will be 30 marks or not. We cannot clearly say that each area is going to carry 30 marks. Now what is the second paper? Three areas are there. The first area says mental ability, but he has included geometry, he has included algebra, everything, mensuration, they are not included. Okay, so basically arithmetic is also there. Now the challenge is with, I'm sure you have a topic called psychological abilities. You must be wondering what is this. Meeku CSAT, are you aware of CSAT? CSAT dentro undi civils law. CSAT introduced aina first 2 years adi qualifying paper gaadu, adi compulsory paper undi. Ippudu CSAT qualifying civils law. Intaku mundu, I mean when it was introduced in 2012, aa time papers chuste adi compulsory paper unde. Okay, ante aggregate kadeyadi appudu meeku indulo decision making, interpersonal skills itlanti topics unde. Meeru ee decision making meed ochina questions chuste, this is the kind of questions you will get here under psychological ability. So don't worry, it is not rocket science, it is simple common sense to be used in certain situations. Atlanti questions ekkuvistaru ikkada. Now the second part of it is science and technology. The third part of it is current affairs. So roughly 40 marks per each area, roughly. Okay, Now, this is very, very lengthy, and this is going to be a challenge for non-MAC students. And they have given details of what you have studied. 10th varak me nechukuna anni concepts almost have been included in this. This again comes under your paper 3 of mains. Ethics ani meeku oka kotta area add chesaru. Dani kinda this part will be covered. S&T will be covered under your which paper? Paper 5 of mains will cover this part of S&T. Okay, so this is your syllabus for paper, I mean general studies and group 1 prelims. Just make a note of this and I'll introduce you to the mains areas. Then we will discuss how to prepare on it. గ్రూప్ ఇంతకుముందు ఏమయ్యేదంటే గ్రూప్ టూకి ప్రిపేర్ అయిన స్టూడెంట్స్ గ్రూప్ వన్ ఫిలిమ్స్ ఈజీగా రాయగలిగే వాళ్ళు. ఇప్పుడు మీరు గ్రూప్ వన్కి ప్రిపేర్ అయితే గ్రూప్ వన్కి మాత్రమే ప్రిపేర్ అవ్వాలి. గ్రూప్ టూకి ప్రిపేర్ అయితే గ్రూప్ వన్కి ఫిలిమ్స్కి పనికిరాదు. సెకండ్ పేపర్ విల్ బీ అ ప్రాబ్లమ్. ఎందుకంటే మీ గ్రూప్ టూలో ఎస్ఎన్టీ ఉండదు. గ్రూప్ టూలో సైకలాజికల్ ఎబిలిటీస్ ఉండవు. గ్రూప్ టూలో మీకు కవర్ చేసే అర్థమెటిక్ దీనికి సరిపోదు. సో గ్రూప్ టూకి ప్రిపేర్ అయ్యే వాళ్ళకి గ్రూప్ వన్ ఫిలిమ్స్ క్లియర్ అవడం కష్టం. పేపర్ 2 ఇస్ గోయింగ్ టు బి డిఫికల్ట్. జాగ్రఫీ కూడా మీకు ఇంత డెప్త్ ఉండదు. గ్రూప్ 2లో ఇంత డెప్త్కి చెప్పరు. సో ఇఫ్ యూర్ టార్గెటింగ్ గ్రూప్ 1 యూ హ్యావ్ టు ప్రిపేర్ ఫర్ ఇట్ సపరేట్లీ. యూ హ్యావ్ టు ప్రిపేర్ అడిషనల్లీ అపార్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ ది ఏరియాస్ దట్ ఆర్ ఆల్రెడీ దేర్. యూ హ్యావ్ టు డూ అడిషనల్ ప్రిపరేషన్. సీ దిస్ విల్ నాట్ బి అ ప్రాబ్లమ్. ఓకే, ఇట్ ఈస్ దేర్ ఇన్ గ్రూప్ 2. This part will not be a problem because it is there in group 2. But this is additional. Idi matram prepare avvalsi vastundi. This will not be a problem. This, the kind of topics that are given, because of which you have to prepare it additionally. Okay? This part, you need additional preparation. Group 2 ki me chadivedi saripodu, group 1 prelims ki. This also you need additional preparation. This will be common, but the only point is this is going to, its weightage is more. So you have to read more. Depth should be greater. Coverage should be greater for group 1. This is just to give an idea on what is common and what is uncommon between group 1 and group 2. ఇంతకు ముందు గ్రూప్ టూ ప్రిపేర్ అయితే గ్రూప్ వన్ ఫిలిమ్స్ ఈజీగా రాయగలిగే వాళ్ళు. ఇప్పుడు ద సిచ్యువేషన్ విల్ నాట్ బి లైక్ దాట్. మీకు సిలబస్ నేర్చుకోవడానికి ఒక వారం 10 రోజులు పడుతుంది. అంతుంది మీ సిలబస్. కానీ అడ్వాంటేజ్ అది, ఎందుకంటే ప్రతి ఒక్క టాపిక్ మెన్షన్ చేశారు. సో యూ విల్ హ్యావ్ మోర్ క్లారిటీ ఆన్ ద సిలబస్. డోంట్ లుక్ ఎట్ ది మ్యాగ్నానిమిటీ ఆఫ్ ద సిలబస్. Finished writing? Now, mains has been increased tremendously. The syllabus has been increased, but there is a cut down in the syllabus also. Some areas they have increased, some areas they have decreased. However, the big change is qualifying papers have been introduced. What are the qualifying papers? Telugu, English have been introduced. You have to pass them in order to clear the exam. Emaitadante mains lo, see, you will have two qualifying papers and five compulsory papers. Aithe ikkada em chestarante, first they will evaluated first. Okay, indulo pass aina vaalla papers maatrame will be evaluated. I repeat, ivi mundi evaluate chestaru, indulo evaraithe clear avtaro vaalla meetha papers maatrame evaluate chestaru, kan mee final result will be based on only these five papers. For the result they consider this, kani in order to evaluate these papers you should first clear qualifying papers. Enduku, why am I emphasizing is, many of us have lost the habit of writing Telugu. Antena 10th class leda civil services lo kuda meeku qualifying Telugu paper untundi. Civil services last 10 years papers practice cheyadam is what I would recommend. Okay, meeku simple grammar e undi, pedda complicated undadu. So I would suggest that civil services Telugu okkasari chusukoni practice chesthe it will be an advantage for you. Now mains has five divisions. Paper 1 as earlier is general essay, kani the difference is earlier they divided it into sections and they told us what will be the topics in each section. Now they did not divide it into section, they gave seven broad areas and they said from these areas you will get essay. So manaki enni essays untai we don't know. Okay, what will be the weightage we don't know. Seven areas lo you also have reflective topics. Have you seen this? Reflective topics. Then you have socio-economic issues, environmental issues, itla they have listed topics. What do you mean by reflective topics? Have you seen the civil services essay paper anytime? They give a statement and they ask you to explain the statement. Chusunte, similar questions will be asked. Ante, but for example, there is a very famous proverb statement of Mahatma Gandhi, there is enough to satisfy every man's need. Okay, but not enough to satisfy a man's greed. Itlanti statements ichi, they will ask you to write on these statements. This is one part of reflective essays. Ideally, choosing this will be a little difficult because justifying the statement is not going to be easy. Kani meeku okavela ive nalugu ichi raayamante option em untadi, because in civils also what they are doing is they are giving four of these and they are asking them to pick one. So deeniki kuda what we can do ideally is you have to prepare, first look at civil services essay papers. Oka 10 years essays chuste meeku oka clarity ostadi. How are they be asking the questions? The pattern is going to heavily rely on civil services. Okay, so idi paper 1. Paper 2 has Indian history, AP history. Addition is geography. Earlier geography was not a subject in mains. Now they have added geography as a subject in mains and it includes both concepts, India and AP. Geography is the new addition. Third paper is the lengthiest paper. God knows what prompted them to put so many areas. Like idokka cheppadaniki rendu nellu padutadi. Polity and constitution. Okay, you have only one chapter of public administration. It is not complete public administration. Basics and Kautilya's reference has been given. Okay, three governance, but governance is going to be a continuity to polity. This is the biggest challenge. Ethics, civils ki 250 marks kun ethics has been concised and included for you in this area. So this is going to take time and it's a totally new part for you. Fifth, the basics in law nature. So they won't dig deeper here. You just need to know the basic tenets of different types of law. Like CRPC, CPC, IPC, one nature, intellectual property rights. So you all these different types of laws, you just need to cover the basic part. Deenikante ekku adagaru. Ikkada kuda the syllabus is lengthy, but the kind of questions is unpredictable. So according to me, out of these five areas, students will find this as challenging because this is the syllabus is a little high compared to the weightage it has been given. Just make a note of these, then I'll give you paper 4 and 5. I'm going to handle this paper myself. Finished? Now, paper 4 is economy, India, AP, kani continuity lo syllabus icharu. India topic immediate ga, AP topic, and this is more advantageous for you. Unnecessary syllabus has been removed from AP. The focus of this part is totally on current issues. Background chala takkundi. It is more dynamic than static. Paper 5. The real change happened in this paper because earlier you had 3 divisions. Environment okatunde, science and tech was the other, space technology was the other, space and defense technology. The third was biotech. Idi mundunna pattern. Idanta thesis eppudu em chesaru, they gave only the chapters. But the point is, they have removed redundant areas from biotechnology and science and technology. They have included current areas, everything including artificial intelligence has been added. Anni, all latest developments in essence has been added to this paper. Okay. Nannadu tete, according to me, the deciding factors will be paper 5. Paper 3. Endukante paper 1 essay, if you are well versed with the remaining 4 papers, essay raayadam pedda problem undadu. Okay. Ee reflective topics ki kuda meeru ethics lo meeku cover aithaya topics anni. So, paper 3, paper 5 are going to decide the result this time. Indian history, AP history, geography is going to be the same. Ikkada, you have to rely heavily on current issues. But these are going to be really challenging. Paper 3 and paper 5 will be the real challenges. Okay, now this is about your syllabus. Coming to your preparation, my first suggestion is, please read the syllabus carefully. You have to get a hang on the syllabus. Complete syllabus idea undal. I've already spoken to the teachers. I've asked each of them to spend about 1 hour or 1 hour on their particular area. Take you through the details of the syllabus. Tell you how they are going to handle it and how you are going to prepare. I've already told them. So, roju meeku okokaru will spend about 1 hour with you. Meeku rep syllabus copies vachestayi. 1 hour meeto koorchoni meeku em cheptaru, ela prepare chestaru meeto vaallu clarity istaru. First, I'll start with my papers. Paper 3 to start just then, you know. I'll tell you how to go about with it. The next session. So, all the teachers are already informed to do that. Nannadu taite, please follow what the institution is saying. Because, you know, in the best of your interest and our interest, we will do what is required for the exam. Okay? So, don't unnecessarily go into too many books. Only refer those books which will be given to you by the faculty. I have already asked them to update the material. Okavela material kaadu ee time saripodu anukunte handouts ichestaru meeku. Topic wise handouts ichestaru. I'll ensure that the material comes to you. I'll ensure that proper tests are being conducted. Endukante emaitadante general ga tests pedithe meeku aa seriousness undadu. Ippudu exam tala meedu undi kabatti meer andaru serious ga diskon raastaru. Tests will be conducted regularly. The teachers will be there to help you. Kani strictly follow what is being told in the institute. Time and again I am repeating this. E syllabus tho me chances this kodanki veelundadu. So whatever the institute says, please strictly follow with that. Okay? Any questions on the syllabus and the pattern? Today I just wanted to give you an overview. Tomorrow I am going to do a session on paper 3. Anything that you would want to know? సిలబస్ ముందు తీసుకొని చదవండి. ఏమైనా చదివితే దాంట్లో ఏముందో తెలిస్తే అప్పుడు డౌట్స్ వస్తాయి. మనం సిలబస్ చూసి భయపడితే కష్టం. ఓకే, ద ఫస్ట్ స్టెప్ టువర్డ్స్ ఇట్. అడ్వాంటేజ్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ సిలబస్ ఇస్ టాపిక్ వైజ్ ఇచ్చున్నారు. సో మీకు ఈజీ అవుతుంది. ఎక్కడ మొదలు పెట్టాలి, ఎటెళ్ళాలి, ఎక్కడ కంప్లీట్ అవుతుంది అన్న క్లారిటీ ఉంటుంది. ఓకే, సిలబస్ చూసి భయపడద్దు. సెకండ్ అడ్వాంటేజ్ ఏంటంటే, ఇన్నేళ్ళు ప్రిపేర్ అయిన వాళ్ళకి సేమ్, ఇప్పుడు ప్రిపేర్ అయ్యే వాళ్ళకి కూడా సేమ్. ఇన్ఫ్యాక్ట్ ఫ్రెషర్స్కి ఎక్కువ అడ్వాంటేజ్ ఉంటుంది. ఎందుకంటే యువర్ లైక్ అ వైట్ పేపర్, మీకు ఎగ్జామ్కి ఏది అవసరమో అంతవరకే చదువుకొని వెళ్తారు. కానీ పాత వాళ్ళకి ఆల్రెడీ ఎగ్జిస్టింగ్ నాలెడ్జ్ని పక్కన పెట్టి మళ్ళీ దే హ్యావ్ టు అప్రోచ్ ఇన్ అ న్యూ వే. దట్స్ గోయిన్ టు బి డిఫికల్ట్ ఫర్ దెమ్. అందుకనే డోంట్ టేక్ ఇట్ యాజ్ అ నెగటివ్ దిస్ థింగ్, స్టార్ట్ ఆన్ అ పాజిటివ్ నోట్. ఐ మై క్లియర్ విత్ దిస్? ఎనీథింగ్ ఎల్స్ దట్ యు వుడ్ వాంట్ టు ఆస్క్ మీ? ఎనీ డౌట్స్? Okay, tomorrow I'm going to ensure that you get the syllabus copy. The same time again, I'm going to see you all tomorrow. I'll tell you what to read for polity and this part, group 2, group 1, polity part, rep and discuss just the syllabus. Okay, thank you.